Airtable just released some brand new date dependency features inside of their software. These features are so powerful that they are changing the way that we are building date dependencies in Airtable. You're no longer stuck using a lot of clunky formulas. Now, with just a few clicks in your setup, you can tell Airtable all of your dates that depend on each other and watch this cascading effect when you make one change in your source data. This sounds pretty wild, so if you're interested in checking it out, stay tuned and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to unlock the full potential of no-code tools. One of our favorite no-code tools is obviously Airtable. It is just dominating in the database space right now, and I can't wait to show off this new date dependency feature because it really allows us to use Airtable like never before for project management. Before we get started though, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're newer to Airtable, or if you just want to make sure that you know all the basic features of Airtable, go ahead and grab my Airtable Crash Course. It's a free crash course that you can sign up for at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. And over the course of a few days, I'll be delivering to you all the key features of Airtable right to your inbox. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. We are going to build from scratch using the new Quick Start app, a brand new task management situation, and then we're going to dive into the cool new date dependencies. So let's get started. In order to build this, and you can follow along in your own Airtable account, go ahead and click on Create and choose your workspace. I will pick Gap Consulting. I want to highlight for you that this is a paid plan. However, Airtable's website currently says that these features are available for everyone. I don't know if that will always be the case, but that is what they say right now. So hopefully, regardless of what plan you're on, you're going to be able to follow along with me. Now go ahead and click on App Quick Start. This is currently in beta, and I love this new feature because it really helps us stand up a brief example with just a few clicks. I want to work on project management because it's going to definitely include some dates. So let's go ahead and make that selection. And then from here, we're going to make sure to assign tasks, because with tasks, we're going to have some due dates, some start, some end dates, all of those things. This is exactly what I want to get started, and I will click on next. So you can see that this is a workflow that's been added for us. That's just fine. And then we are going to choose if we have any data to import. I don't have that. I just want to start with sample data. We can name the app. This will be task example. We can give it a new color thanks to the quick setup within Quick Start apps, and then we'll click finish. So I'm happy with this. This is looking pretty good. It's now going to create that app. Pretty simple one because we only picked one key feature, and it's going to load up in just a moment our new interface. Now the interface is cool, but this is not where I want to work from. I prefer to work from the data source itself, especially when I'm building something. You might have a different preference if you like building inside of interfaces, and interfaces are a great feature. I don't mean to take away from that, but for this particular feature, we need to be in the data source itself. So I'm going to actually right click on here and open this in a new tab and pop on over to the data. I'm doing this in a new tab so that I can actually go back to the interface at the end of this video to verify that the interface still allows me to take control of these cool features once I've implemented them. So you'll see right off the bat, we have a pretty basic task setup here in our data source. I've got four different tasks, descriptions for these tasks. They've all been assigned to, well, two of them have been assigned to me. I'm going to assign all four of them to me. We have start dates, boom, end dates, all right, a status and a priority. Now, before we get started, let's go ahead and click into the start date. And this is where you're going to see the enablement for the date shifting. So what we're doing here is we're going to establish the dependencies for these dates. We're going to say, hey, this is how these dates interrelate. This is what they mean and signify. And a change in one of these dates is going to potentially create a cascading effect across many different dates. You'll see what I mean if that seems a little vague right now. But if we click on configure, we're going to get a glimpse of what we need. Now, number one, we have an optional predecessor field. I am going to demonstrate this, but not in my first example. We need a start date field. We need an end date field. We already have both of these, but we do not have a duration field. This is a required field for this. Lastly, we have the advanced options section where we can choose to omit holidays and weekends. In this particular case, I'm going to keep that toggled off, but do know that if you select this, then we are going to not count weekends in our calculations, and you can additionally add some holidays that you want to exclude from your calculations as well. If you're taking certain days off, you don't want them showing up in your timelines. Okay, so let's go ahead and get out of here just for a second, and we're going to build that duration field. So I'm going to left click here and just insert a field, and I'll call it duration. And I'm going to make sure to use the duration field type, and I want to calculate my duration in days. I don't necessarily need hours or smaller. I can go with days right here, and we'll create the field. All right, that was easy enough. I now have the three key components for my date dependencies. So let's toggle this feature on and get it buzzing up. All right, so click on any of these dates again, in this case, my start date, and I'm going to go back to configure my date dependencies. You'll notice that I get a choice of the table. Of course, it's in my tasks table here. And I'm going to, as I said, come back to the predecessor. So first pick my start date, here it is. Second, pick my end date, here it is. And lastly, pick my duration, easy enough, and we save. That's simple, right? Now, of course, I also have to save the field itself. So I was inside of the settings of the date dependency, so I've now established this feature, I've toggled it on, and I have to save that. But here is the magic. You'll see that already I've calculated the duration between the start and the end date. Here is the key difference, my friends, between what is happening here with this date dependency feature and what the old Airtable did. If you watch a video from 2 years ago where I'm talking about this exact same topic, I will tell you that you need to pick two of these three. Maybe you pick the start date and the end date, and you will calculate the third. And this is a little bit rigid, right? It means that we can change our start dates, but we can never really change our duration. And the reason for that is the duration would always be calculated. But the key difference here is that I have three different fields. There's no calculation that I had to type, no clunky formula, nothing like that. All I've done is I've established the relationship between two dates and a duration field, one start, one end, one duration. And now a change to any of these fields will be reflected in other fields that depend on that. So for example, if I change my start date here, let's say this was actually supposed to be 2024, right? January 2024, you see that as I make that change, my end date recalculates as well. Because I made a change to my start date, my Airtable account knows that this particular task takes 32 days, and so it's going to calculate 32 days from there. By the way, I should point out that this is calculating using the start date as like day zero, and January has 31 days, and so 32 days from there is what gets us to Feb 1. But this kind of thing applies throughout all of my dates. If I make a change to any one of these three fields, it will be reflected in the other fields. If I cut this down and I say, this is only a 21 day duration, well then it's going to reduce the end date to be 21 days after the start date. If I change the end date, let's say I say 2-1 here, 2022. When I make that change, well then, we have this reverse calculation happening where it says, oh, well then, I need to subtract 13 days and rewind us. Now, in some cases, we get this little warning in the bottom left corner that pops up and it says, hey, there's an invalid dependency, what's going on? And we can see here, oh, look, I made that change. This is not consistent. There's a duration inconsistency with what we have here. Let's fix it. And so just like that, we click fix and it makes those changes. So depending on the dates that we change, sometimes it has a difficult time recalculating. And it looks like specifically if I make a change to the end date, Airtable's not really sure, should I shorten the duration? Should I recalculate the start date? So we see that there's a little bit of a friction point there, but for the most part, this is pretty impressive, right? But I haven't even gotten to the best part of it yet. I haven't shown you how we can link these tasks together and take advantage of dependencies within our tasks. Look at this. I'm going to add yet another field, and I'm going to call this dependent tasks. And I'm going to link to a record in my tasks table. So this is a self-linking table, and I will allow it to link to multiple records, and I'll create this field. Now, what I can do is come in and assign dependent tasks. So before I can complete my updating of the financial report, maybe I have to wait for this design new website to be completed so I can make that selection. This task, task two, depends on task one. Next, I might assign task one and task two here to be dependent for task three. And task four down here might rely on task three being completed. So we have this dependency now established, and we can add this to our configuration in our features. So inside of our date dependencies, we add the predecessor field, and it's that dependent tasks, that self-linking tasks table. And you'll notice that we're getting a little flag. There's three invalid dependencies. Let's view them and let's fix them. And what this is going to do is allow our entire table of data to recalculate. So what's happening is it's saying, well, look, this particular task right here ends on Feb 1, and this task relies on this task. See the dependency. So we know that this task cannot start until after this one is done. So if this ends on Feb 1, this has to start on Feb 2. And then this task, task three, plan team building event, relies on these first two tasks to be complete. So whichever of these two dates is greater, that's going to be the last date that we can start. So here it is on Feb 19th. This has recalculated to start, and so on and so forth. Now check out the magic at work. This used to require tons of automation, tons of formulas. But if I make a change here to my duration, let's say, and I make this a 45-day duration, everything recalculates immediately. Like, that's insane, right? All of these things just recalculated. It had my start date, I changed the duration, gave me a new end date, but then all of these dependent tasks automatically recalculate their start dates, and then automatically recalculate their end dates based on their duration. This is wild. I'm not kidding when I tell you this is changing the game. It used to be that we had to put so many formulas, so many automations into play, and we didn't have the flexibility. And now we can make edits to any of these fields, and it's going to instantly be reflected in all those other places. Now, as a last test, now that we've made the changes in our data source itself, I want to pop back into my interface. Here I am in my interface. If I make a change to my lovely little interface, am I going to see it? Well, before I start making changes, let's first edit what we see here. I'm going to come into my interface. I don't need to see the tour, and I need to make sure that I'm adding the field type of start date. In order to do that, I'm going to come up to fields, and I'm going to find my start date. And let's also add our duration as well. And I can get rid of assignee. I'm not too worried about that. I'm going to get rid of the status. I'm going to make sure I have the task name. I want the start date on top of the end date. Come on. There we go. And I feel pretty good about that. I'll bring in my dependent tasks as well. And one last thing, I see that there is a bit of a filter being applied here. So here on this tab, I'm only seeing my open tasks. So I want to make sure that I'm clicked over to all tasks so that I can see all of these things. And lastly, I'm going to want to apply a sort so that I see these things from start to finish. So let's go ahead and publish these changes. I'm now going to pop into my interface. Again, I want to remind you that this whole interface was created with the new Quick Start apps from Airtable. But here I am inside of my live interface. I'm in all tasks. I'm going to apply a sort here, and I want a sort from end date. So I'm looking at roughly the same data that I had in my data source. Can I make changes now to this and see those changes being reflected in all of the related tasks and critical components? Let's see. Here I am, start date. Let's say that this project got pushed out a month and it's not going to start until Feb 1. I make the change. Look at the recalculation. That quickly, everything was updated. We have the pop-up down here that's telling us that three dependent tasks were updated with the change of that one date. All of this now making sense and perfectly aligned with the updates I made. I'm pretty impressed by this new feature. I hope you are too. If there's something about it that I didn't quite capture, be sure to drop your comments or questions below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.